Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. In today's video guys, we'll show you how to remove and replace front window motor on Ford Fiesta, the generation from 2008 to 2017. This is the motor right here. Some might have different part numbers. Always check to make sure that it fits on yours. Okay, this is the new one that we got. So let's go ahead and replace it now. Okay guys, so now we can go ahead, open the door. Okay, we'll need to go ahead and remove the door panel. So what we recommend guys is to use panel removal tools right here, so we can make sure that we don't scratch anything. Okay, so we will get a little bitty screwdriver, and right here guys we have a cap. So if you open the door handle, there is a place where you can pry that cap open. Just careful not to break it. Okay, it is just like this one right here. Okay, you pull them out like that. That's how it's supposed to be. The other one, they just broke it. Okay, we have one more on the bottom right here. Next we'll need a door removal or door panel removal too. Okay, because we'll need to remove that cap on the door handle right here. Good thing about those is that you don't scratch the trims with it. You still have to be careful, but it's not like you're prying with a screwdriver. Okay, that's how we pull this one out. Okay, now we're gonna get the long screwdriver with a T20 bit. Okay, let me show you. This one is the star looking bit. Okay, like that, T20, and we need to go ahead and remove that screw on top. Okay, this one is out. And we have two more where we open the caps right here. Okay, you can see this one is coming out and this cap stays here. If you want, actually, you can remove those. Okay, like that. They're replaceable. I'll just take this one off not to lose it. And we need to remove the one on the bottom as well. Next, most likely we'll need a little bit bigger bit. We need to check because we have two screws. Okay, one right here and one on top. And those are with T25, just the next step bigger. Okay, so we'll go ahead and remove the one on top. And we'll remove the one on the bottom as well. Make sure guys you subscribe. We'll probably have about 150 to 200 videos on that car. So if you need something, you know that we will have it most likely. If not, just let us know and we'll try to make a video for it. Okay, we are ready with removing this one now. Okay, we definitely need to detail it, but we'll do that when we're done working on it. Okay, this one is loose, but it doesn't want to come out. You can get a magnetic screwdriver. That's what I like about those, that you can magnetize any screwdriver and you can pull it out. Okay, we'll get another panel removal too. Okay, and it's important, to pry the panel out now. It has a few clips here and there. Sometimes it's really tight if it's never been removed, so we'll just start on the front side. It started coming out there first. Okay, now we have to lift it up because it needs to come out of the groove. Okay, right here. Okay, and we have one more clip right there that's holding. Okay, like that, came out. It's important not to pull too much. You always have to make sure you check everything around. Stay with us, we'll show you where all the clips are now. Next, we need to disconnect the cable for unlocking, for the door handle, for opening the door. Okay guys, so we'll show you exactly what it is. There is one plastic piece right here that you need to pry towards the back. Okay, this one right there. It has two clips and then you push the cable towards the front. Okay, let me show you now quick what I'm talking about. Okay, this one, you can see it has two teeth, okay, right here. So you need to do that and pull it out. Next, we need to go ahead and disconnect all the wires. Okay, and this one is a little bit tricky now because it's hard to see there. But first we'll remove the speaker wire, okay, right there. You just push in that centerpiece and pull it out so we can have a little bit more room for the mirror switch wires there now. Okay, so you can pry them a little bit with a screwdriver on the side. There is two teeth that hold that. And if you cannot get that wire, okay, let me show you what you can do. If you push from the back side, okay, the top end of the thing will come out, okay, like that. And then you pull it out, okay, like that. Okay, now let me show you where the wire is. Okay, actually the tube is on the bottom. That's why it's good, guys, to watch the video before we're taking things apart. Okay, and you can just pull the wire out. When you're ready to install it, okay, let me just show you that because you need to know that. You need to go, okay, like that. Okay, it goes in a certain angle and you push it in like that. Okay, guys, next we have quite a few more wires here to disconnect. Okay, on this one here, that's the first one. You push the middle piece in and pull out. Okay, we have that big one. Same thing. Okay, we have one more. Two more, actually. One more. Okay, that green one. Okay, you can see this is the thing that you need to press in. Okay, and then you pull the wire out. And usually if they're stuck, you need to push in a little bit first, push the button and pull it out. Okay, now you can see one of our clips is missing. It came from the door panel, so now we need to go ahead and remove that clip and actually install it, okay, down here. Okay, so we removed it with our tool and we just install it on the door panel. So now let me show you where all the clips are. You can see you have two on the front, on the bottom you have three, and three on this side. Okay, this is the one that we had to be careful with because it came loose. Alright, guys, we removed the door panel. So let's go ahead and remove the window molding now. So we're needing the T25. Okay, start looking big. Right here. We have three screws that you need to remove. Okay, once you do that, you can go ahead gently. One person have to hold the window, or you have to tape your window down because it will try to go down on you. Now we need to disconnect the wire. Okay, you can get from underneath and pry it because sometimes they don't go out. You have to press on this one, okay, and you pull it out. Okay, you can see when you press, okay, that thing moves up and down. Okay, that's the old motor right here. Okay, we got the new motor already. Now you need to get in the teeth there. Okay, you might need to turn a little bit to adjust it where exactly all three screws can get in. Okay, and get them tight. Don't over tighten those because you might crack the plastic. Okay, a little bit. Okay, one more, and then we will just need to connect the wire, okay, and put the door panel together, and that will be, guys, the whole procedure. So thank you guys for watching, please subscribe, and see you guys next time.